y'all. My name is Shaylin Taylor, and I will be doing day 13, the mystery from the Stepping Forward devotion by Mike Lienfelter. So I'll be reading Ephesians 3, 1 through 6, and I will be reading some of the points from the insight and also the challenge and the reflection. So let's get started. Let me find it. Okay. Here we are. Okay, Ephesians 3, 1 through 6. For this reason, I, Paul, the prisoner of Christ Jesus, for the sake of you Gentiles, if indeed you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace, which was given to me for you, that by revelation there was made known to me the mystery as I wrote before in brief. By referring to this, when you read, you can understand my insight into the mystery of Christ, which in other generations was not made known to the sons of men, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets in the Spirit, to be specific, that the Gentiles are fellow heirs and fellow members of the body and fellow partakers of the promise of Christ in Christ Jesus through the gospel. So, really quick, I just want to explain the meaning of grace, and it is whenever someone deserves something and you don't give it to them. So this, it's really hard to demonstrate and really hard for most of us to put to action, but fortunately it is not hard for God. So we've got that going for us. So I'm just really gonna quick break up this these six verses into two different parts so that we can kind of fully grasp it and understand what it is saying. So here we go. For this reason, I, Paul, the prisoner of Christ Jesus, for the sake of you Gentiles, if indeed you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace, which was given to me for you, that by revelation there was made known to me the mystery as I wrote before in brief. So in the first part, Paul talks about how God's grace is revealed to him, and it is it was given to him, and he is giving it to us to understand. So he's saying that he's sharing it with us right here where it says, if indeed you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace, which was given to me for you. So he's sharing it. He understands it. He feels it. He grasps it. And now he's revealing it to us and he's showing it to us. So in this second part, it says, by referring to this, when you read, you can understand my insight into the mystery of Christ, which in other generations was not made known to the sons of men, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets in the Spirit, to be specific, that the Gentiles are fellow heirs and fellow members of the body and fellow partakers of the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. So in this part, in the second part, excuse me, Paul's saying how he's been given the opportunity to share it, and he's been given the opportunity to reveal it. And others before him, it says, in other generations was not made known to the sons of men. So it's not that God's grace wasn't made known, but they didn't really understand it or comprehend it or know about it. So Paul's saying, I understand it and I'm sharing it with you. So it also says in the last part, to be specific, that the Gentiles are fellow heirs and fellow members of the body and fellow partakers of the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. So this is actually kind of like a third part. Paul's saying that Gentiles, we're all one. We all have God's grace and we're all together in this. We're all fellow heirs, we're all fellow partakers, and we are all partakers of the promise of Christ Jesus through the gospel. So that's a super important part. I'm going to read the insight really quick. I'm not going to go through and read the whole thing. I'm actually just going to kind of read some of the important parts that I thought were, that I thought spoke to me, and I thought I understood it better because of it. So it says, when we see the word mystery, we often think of a mysterious plot involving some crime that has occurred. We wonder what clues there are, who the criminal is, and how he is to be captured. So honestly, I think that everybody can agree that that's what mystery is. I mean, you turn on the TV and you watch a mystery show and that's what it's about. But actually, this is not about that. It's about the mystery of God's grace, which was a mystery to those who don't know him. So people who don't know God, they don't understand it. It's confusing. It's not revealed to them. But Paul's giving us the opportunity and giving the opportunity to those who don't understand it to comprehend it and for it to be revealed to them. So the next part that I'm going to talk about is how it was Paul's job to share it with us. He wanted us to know, just like God wanted all of us to understand it. God wanted to show us that he has grace and that he has it for everyone. He has it for Gentiles, not just for the Jews. He has it for everyone. And so Paul says that in the verse, and it's important to know that he was showing it to us and that he's trying to reveal it to us, and he was giving us the opportunity to understand it. So the next part of the insight that Pastor Mike brought to light to me, because I did not know, was the three truths that are included in God's grace, which I didn't even know about. I didn't even know that was a thing, but after reading this, it was kind of crazy to me, and I was like, wow, that is so cool. So I'm going to share it really quick. So I'm not going to share it word for word, but I am going to kind of get the point across. So the three truths were, the first one was that all believers, no matter if it was 100 years ago or today, we are all descendants of Abraham if you are a believer. That is a truth, and I think that is amazing to know and helpful. The second truth is that we are all believers are one body of Christ. So we all have different churches. Benson's got a bunch of different churches. All around the world, we have so many churches. But if you are a believer of Christ and you are following him, we are all one. We are all a body and we are all together. So I just love that, and I'm super glad that he said that. So the third truth is that all of God's promises are true. So for me, it really spoke to me that all of God's promises are true, you know? It is good to know that God's promises are serious and he means what he says. So the promises of heaven, the promises of eternal life, and the promises of God's kingdom are all true, and we can always count on that. And that's all included in God's grace and God's mystery. So that's all talked about in the insight. So I hope y'all will get to read that. Anyways, we're going to go through with the challenge, and I'm just going to read it word for word really quick. Let us praise God that we are all well within the reach of his grace. Let us prostrate ourselves before the throne of the King and show him how humble we are, that he would include us in his grace. Would it not be appropriate to do that now? Why wait any longer to come before the throne of grace and make our praises known? What God has done, no man can duplicate or force into existence. What God has shown, no person could dream of. He has flooded us with his grace. He has showered us upon his mercy. He has revealed to us a great mystery. Should we not take this time to make our praise known? So that's kind of a personal thing. And all I'm saying is, y'all, that's what I want to do. So that really spoke to me, and I hope it does the same for you. So the next part I'm going to do is the reflection. And I'm going to kind of just talk about it really quick, what it meant to me. So it says, what is God saying to me right now? So right now, as I read the devotion, what it kind of said to me, which is crazy because this is what's going on in our world right now, is that God's grace is for everyone. God's grace was meant for everyone. It was meant to be shared, it was meant to be revealed, and it was meant to be understood and experienced. And that is so important, that we need to know it, we need to share it, we need to make that our life. And I don't know, I guess that's just what I felt like, that's what God put on my heart. So the next part of the reflection is, how should I respond? So for me, I want to live it out. I want God's grace to be a part of my life. I want to show God's grace. I want to experience it, and I want it to be a part of my life. I want to reveal it to others, and every day I want that to be my goal. I'm a very goal and oriented person, and I want that to be my goal when I wake up. And I hope that you all can do the same. I really enjoyed this day of the devotion, and I hope you all did too, and I hope you all have a great day. Bye.